tell mama. I'll tell mama.
You beat!
Hush, what is this? My lord. Order, order. I'm obliged.
Well, good morning to you, Mr. Hodge.
Will you join us this morning, Lord Augustus? We have only our drawing lesson.
I am a master at Eton, Mr. Hodge, but we only draw naked women.
You may work from memory.
Disgusting!
We'll have silence now, if you please.
No, Marx! Did you not like my rabbit equation?
I saw no resemblance to a rabbit.
It eats its own progeny.
I did not see that.
I have not room to extend it. Do you mean the world is saved after all?
No, it's still doomed. But if this is how it started, perhaps it's how the next one will come.
From good English algebra?
It will go to infinity or zero, or nonsense.
No, if you set apart the minus roots, they square back to cents.
Oh, listen, you know your tea's getting cold.
I like it cold.
I'm telling you something. Your tea gets cold by itself. It doesn't get hot by itself. Do you think that's odd?
No.
Well, it is odd. Heat goes to cold. It's a one-way street. Your tea will end up at room temperature. What's happening to your tea is happening to everything everywhere. The sun and the stars. It'll take a while, but we're all going to end up at room temperature. When your hermit set up shop, nobody understood this. But let's say you're right. In 18-whatever, nobody knew about heat than this scribbling nutter living in a hovel in Derbyshire.
He was at Cambridge, a scientist.
Say he was, I'm not arguing. And the girl was his pupil. She had a genius for her tutor.
Or the other way around.
Anything you like, but not this. Whatever he thought he was doing to save the world with good English algebra, it wasn't this.
Why, because he didn't have calculators?
No. Yes, because there's an order things can't happen. You can't open a door until there's a house.
I thought that's what genius was.
Only for lunatics and poets.
I had a dream, which was not all a dream. The bright sun was extinguished, and the stars did wander, darkling in the eternal space, rayless and pathless, and the icy earth swung blind and blackening in the moonless air.
Your own?
Byron. Septimus, do you think that I will marry Lord Byron?
Who is he?
He is the author of Childe Harold's Pilgrimage, the most poetical and pathetic and bravest hero of any book I have ever read before. And the most modern and the handsomest, for Harold is Lord Byron himself to those who know him, like myself and Septimus. Well, Septimus?
No.
Why not?
For one thing, he's not aware of your existence.
We exchanged many significant glances when he was at Sidley Park. I do wonder that he's been home almost a year from his adventures and has not written to me once.
It is indeed improbable, my lady.
Lord Byron, he claimed my hair. Although my shot was earlier, he said I missed it by a hair's breadth. His conversation was facetious, and I think Lord Byron will not marry me, Thumb, for he was only lame and not blind.
Peace. Peace until 11:45. It is intolerable for a tutor to have his thoughts interrupted by his pupils.
You are not my tutor, sir. I am visiting your lesson by my own free will.
You are so determined, my lord.
Your peace is nothing to me, sir. You do not rule over me.
Augustus!
I do not rule here, my lord. I inspire by reverence for learning and the exaltation of knowledge whereby man may approach God. There will be a shilling for the best cone and pyramid drawn in silence by 11:45 at the earliest.
You will not buy my silence for a shilling, sir, but I know that fellow is worth much more than that.
I told you he kissed me, but he will not tell.
When did I kiss you?
What? Yesterday.
Where?
On the lips.
In which county?
In the Hermitage, Septimus.
On the lips in the Hermitage? That? That was not a shilling's kiss. I would not give 6 pence to have it back. I had almost forgot about it already.
Oh, cruel! Have you forgotten our compact?
God save me, what compact?
To teach me to waltz, so that a kiss and a second kiss do when I can dance like Mama.
Yes, indeed. We were all waltzing like mice in London.
I must waltz, Septimus. I will be despised if I do not waltz. Is the most fashionable and gayest and boldest invention conceivable. Started in Germany.
Let them have their waltz. They cannot have calculus.
Mama has brought from town a whole book of waltzes for the Broadway to play with Count Zelinsky.
I need not to be told what I cannot but suffer. Count Zelinsky banging on my Broadway without Wildly has me reading in Walt's time.
Oh, stuff. What is your book?
A prize essay of the Scientific Academy in Paris. The author deserves your indulgence, my lady, for you are its prophet.
What does he write about? The waltz?
Yes. He demonstrates the equation of the propagation of heat in a solid body. But in doing so, he has discovered here's a natural contradiction, Sir Isaac Newton.
Oh, he contradicts determinism?
No. Well, perhaps. He shows that the atoms do not go according to Newton.
Let me see. Oh, in French?
Yes. Paris is the capital of France.
Show me where to read. Four-handed now. Mama is in love with the Count.
He is a Count in Poland. In Derbyshire, he is a piano tutor.
Forgive my brother's marriage. We must be thankful the monkey bit the husband. If it had bit the wife, the monkey would be dead, and we would not be first in the kingdom to show Adalia. I sent one postcard to Chatsworth. The Duchess was satisfactorily put out by it when I called at Devonshire House. Your friend was there, lording it as a poet.
I said, Newton's machine, which would not hurt atoms from cradle to grave by the laws of motion, is incomplete. Determinism leaves the road at every corner, as it knew all along, and the cause is very likely hidden in this gentleman's observation.
Of what?
The actions of body and heat.
Is this geometry?
This? No, I despise geometry.
The chain would overthrow the Newtonian system in a week.
Geometry. Hobbes assures us in the Leviathan. Is the only science God has been pleased to bestow on mankind.
And what does it mean by it?
Mr. Hobbes or God?
I am sure I do not know what either means by it.
Oh, Cuda Hobbes, mountains are not pyramids and trees are not cones. God must love gunnery and architecture if Euclid is his only geometry. There is another geometry which I am engaged in discovering by trial and error. Am I not Septimus?
Trial and error perfectly describes your enthusiasm, my lady.
How old are you today?
16 years and 11 months, Mama, and 3 weeks.
16 years and 11 months. We must have you married before you are educated beyond eligibility.
I'm going to marry Lord Byron.
Are you? He did not have the manners to mention it.
You've spoken to him?
Certainly not.
Where did you see him?
Everywhere.
Did you, Septimus?
At the Royal Academy, where I had the honor to accompany your mother in council.
What was Lord Byron doing?
Posing.
He was being sketched during his visit by the professor of painting, Mr. Poulos.
There was more posing at the picture than in them. His companion likewise reversed the custom of the academy that the ladies viewing were more than the ladies viewed. Well enough. Let him be hanged there for a lamb. I have enough with Mr. Noakes, who is to a guard. are and what a bull is to a Chinese.
The Emperor of Irregularity,
Mr. Noakes.
Your ladyship.
What have you done to me?
Everything is satisfactory, I assure you. A little behind, to be sure, but my dam will be repaired within a month.
Hush! Can you hear, Mr. Noakes?
The improved Newcomen's steam pump, the only one in England.
That is what I object to. If everyone had his own, I would bear my portion of the agony without complaint. But to have been singled out by the only improved Newtonian steam pump in England, this is hard, sir. This is not to be borne.
Your lady.
And for what? My lake is drained to a ditch for no purpose I can understand. Unless it be that Snipe and Curlew have deserted three countries so that they may be shot to our swamp. What you painted as forest is a mean plantation. Your greenery is mud. Your waterfall is wet mud. And your mount is an open cast mine for the mud that was lacking in the cell. What is that cowshed?
The Hermitage, my lady.
It is a cowshed.
Madam, it is, I assure you, a very habitable cottage. Properly founded and drained, two rooms and a closet under a slate roof and a stone chimney.
Who is to live in it?
Why, the hermit.
Where is he?
Madam.
You surely did not supply a hermitage without a hermit.
Indeed, madam.
Come, Mr. Ross. If I have promised a fountain, I expect it to come with water. What hermits do you have?
I have no hermits, my lady.
Not one? I am speechless.
I am sure a hermit could be found. One could advertise.
Advertise?
In the newspapers.
But surely a hermit who takes a newspaper is not a hermit in whom one can have complete confidence.
I do not know what to suggest, my lady.
Is there room for a piano?
Piano?
We're intruding here. This will not do. Mr. Hodge. Evidently, nothing is being learned. Come along, sir.
Oh, no. No.
I'm sorry, Bernard.
Fucked by a Dahlia. Do you think it is? Is it open and shut? Am I fucked? What does it really amount to, when all's said and done? Am I fucked? What do you think, Valentine? Tell me the truth.
You're fucked.
Oh, God. Does it mean that?
Yes, Bernard, it does.
I'm not sure. Show me where it says it. I want to see it. No, read it. No, wait. Right?
October 1st, 1810. Today, under the direction of Mr. Noakes, a parterre was dug on the south lawn and will be a handsome show next year, a consolation for the picturesque catastrophe of the second and third distances. The Dahlia, having propagated under glass with no ill effect from the sea voyage, is named by Captain Bryce Charity for his bride, though the honor properly belongs to the husband who exchanged beds with my Dahlia and an English summer for everlasting night in the Indies.
Well, it's so around the house, isn't it? Who's to say what it means?
It means that Ezra Chater of the Sidley Park Connection is the same Chater who described a dwarf Dahlia in Martinique in 1810 and died there of a monkey bite.
Ezra wasn't a botanist. He was a poet.
He was not much of either, but he was both.
Of course it's a disaster.
It's not a disaster.
Of course it was a disaster. I was on the breakfast hour.
It doesn't mean Byron didn't fight a duel. It only means Chater wasn't killed in it.
Oh, pull yourself together. Do you think I'd been on the breakfast hour if Byron had missed?
Calm down, Bernard. Valentine's right.
Do you think so? You mean the Piccadilly Reviews? Yes, two completely unknown Byron essays? And my discovery of the lines he added to the English bards? That counts for something.
Very possible. Persuasive indeed.
Oh, bugger persuasive. I've heard Byron was there, and as far as I'm concerned, he wrote those lines as sure as he shot that hare. If only I hadn't somehow made it all about the killing journey. Why didn't you stop me? It's bound to get out, you know? I mean this gloss on my discovery. I mean, how long do you think it'll be before some botanical pedant blows the whistle on me?
The day after tomorrow. A letter in the Times.
You wouldn't.
It's a dirty job, but somebody...
Darling. Sorry, Hannah.
And after all, it is my discovery.
Hannah.
Bernard.
Anna.
Oh, shut up. It'll be very short, very dry, absolutely lilt-free. Would you rather it were one of your friends?
Oh, God, no.
And then in your letter to the Times...
Mine?
Well, of course. Dignified congratulations to a colleague in the language of scholars, I trust.
Oh, eat shit, you mean.
Think of it as a breakthrough in Dahlia's studies.
Why aren't you coming? Bernard, you're not even dressed. How long have you been back?
Why are you wearing those clothes?
Do be quick. Just put anything on. We're all being photographed, except Hannah.
I'll come and watch.
Mommy says you've got the theater light.
What are you supposed to be, Chloe? Bo Peep?
Jane Austen.
Of course.
Oh, it's in the Hermitage. Sorry.
I thought it was until this evening. What photograph?
The local paper, of course. They always come before we start. We want a good crowd of us. Gus looks gorgeous.
The newspaper? I'm ready. My lady, what is it?
Septimus, shush! Now is our chance.
For what, dear God?
Do not act innocent. Tomorrow will be 17.
Dear Christ!
Now you must show me. You are paid in advance.
Oh?
The count plays for us. It is God-given. I cannot be 17 and not waltz.
But your mother?
While she swoons, we can dance. The house is all abed. I heard the Broadwood. Oh, Septimus, teach me now.
Hush, I cannot.
Indeed you can, and I am come barefoot, so mind my toes.
I cannot because it is not a waltz.
It is not?
No, it is too slow for waltzing.
Oh, then we will wait for him to play quickly.
My lady.
Mr. Hodge. Are you reading my essay? Why do you work here so late?
It is mine again. You should have written in it.
It was a joke.
It will make me mad as you promise. Sit over there. You will have us in disgrace.
If Mama comes, I will tell her we only meant to kiss, not to waltz.
Silence or bed?
Silence. Oh.
Got it. It's heat.
Are you tight, Val?
It's a diagram of heat exchange.
So we're all doomed?
Yes!
Like a steam engine, you see. She didn't have the maths, not remotely. She saw what things meant, way ahead, like seeing a picture.
This is not science, this is storytelling.
Is it a waltz, though?
No.
Like a film.
What did she see?
That you can't run the film backwards. Heat was the first thing which didn't work that way. Not like Newton. A film of a pendulum or a ball falling through the air. Backwards, it looks the same.
The ball would be going the wrong way.
You'd have to know that, but with heat.
Who thought it did?
She saw why. You can put back the bits of glass, but you can't collect the heat of the smack.
Southern Brood Newtonian Universe must see it grow cold. Dear me.
The heat goes into the mix.
Yes, we must hurry if we're going to dance.
And everything is mixing the same way, all the time, irreversibly.
Oh, we have time, I think.
Till there's no time left. That's what time means.
When we have found all the mysteries and lost all the meaning, we will be all alone, on an empty shore.
Then we will dance. Is this a waltz?
It will serve.
Good!
Should I go? No. I'm going.
kill her.
Oh dear.
What the hell is it, Chloe?
Mommy!
Your mother caught us in that cottage.
She snooped.
I don't think so. She was rescuing a theodolite.
I'll come with you, Bernard.
No, you bloody won't.
Don't you want me to?
Of course not. What for? I'm sorry.
What are you saying sorry to him for?
Sorry to you too. Sorry one and all. Sorry, Hannah. Sorry, Hermione. Sorry, Byron. Sorry, sorry, sorry. Now can I go?
Well, what a bastard you are, Bernard. And you mind your own business. What do you know about anything?
Nothing.
It was worth it though, wasn't it?
It was wonderful.
Nothing.
Well, you shit. I drive you, but I'm a bit sloshed.
A scrape.
Oh, Bernard.
I look forward to the genius of the place. I hope you find your hermit. I think out front is the safest.
Actually, I've got a good idea who he was, but I can't prove it.
Publish.
Yes, my lady. Take your essay. I've given it an alpha to blind faith. Be careful with the flame.
I will wait for you to come.
I cannot.
You may.
I may not.
You must.
I will not.
Then I will not go. For once more. For my birthday. Septimus Holding Clavis. I was looking for that. Thank you. Oh dear, I don't really...